At 10 a.m. local time on July 23, 2024, a powerful explosion unexpectedly occurred at the Yellowstone Volcano in Wyoming. As the ground surrounding the Black Diamond Pole and the Biscuit Basin geothermal area of the park exploded upwards, multiple tons of mud and rock were thrown up to 100 meters or 330 feet away. Thankfully, no one was harmed despite the proximity of many tourists, with what had just occurred representing a geologic phenomena that, while it might initially look like a volcanic eruption, is not one, instead being referred to as a hydrothermal explosion. While the Yellowstone volcano is well known among geologists for occasionally producing hydrothermal explosions, what if I were to tell you that the July 2024 event wasn't the only hydrothermal explosion to occur in the Northern Hemisphere during the 21st century? As, heading over to Europe, specifically 63 kilometers northwest of the city of Messina in Italy, the exact same phenomena occurred on November 3, 2002. Between 3:30 and 5 a.m. local time on that date, while not directly observed, a large explosion occurred at shallow depths which released substantial amounts of gas, leaving behind a 20-meter-long, 14-meter-wide, and 10-meter-deep depression in the ground that resulted in the deaths of thousands of fish. While not known at the time, the observation of this event will lead to an interesting revelation. The adjacent populated island of Panarea, population 280, does not represent a long dormant volcano like so many had thought. Instead, it is likely still active. Later, nearby and to the north, an additional 44 similar hydrothermal explosion craters were found, some of which measured as much as a whopping 126 meters or 413 feet wide. Yet, these phenomena can theoretically occur far away from an active volcano, such as the 1951 explosions observed in Lake City, California. However, what cannot be denied as evidence that the Panarea volcano is still active is the fact that a major pumice deposit referred to as the Draoutou pumice lies between two layers dated to 8,700 and 24,000 years ago. Based on my own analysis, it seems to me that this pumice deposit, which is associated with a shallow submarine VEI-3 eruption, is highly likely to have occurred during the younger range of these estimates, suggesting an eruption did in fact occur sometime in the last 10,000 years. If correct, this means that Panarea fits the crucial criteria of having produced at least one Holocene eruption to meet the definition of an active volcano, with the Holocene epoch having begun in 9700 BCE. So, exactly how hazardous is the Panarea volcano, and what is its geologic history? Well, if we were to utilize the U.S. Geological Survey methodology for rating volcanoes, Panarea will be classified as a high-threat volcano. A significant portion of this designation is due to the implied threat a future silica-rich eruption could cause to regional air traffic for a time. I want to note that the aforementioned threat score is the lowest of four regional Aeolian Islands that are known or suspected of being active volcanoes. For reference, the Panarea volcano consists of a cluster of lava domes, lava flows, small volcanic cones, and tephra deposits that span this 340 square kilometer region. As you can see, the vast majority of this complex's edifice is underwater, with its edifice having grown initially from as much as 1,300 meters below the surface of the Mediterranean Sea. This entire edifice formed during the last 155,000 years. Thus, here is a brief overview. Panarea Island formed via a sequence of eruptions between 155,000 and 110,000 years ago, first by a group of overlapping lava domes which was then overlaid by a viscous coulee, and then that was partially overlaid by a series of ridge-forming basaltic andesite eruptions. To the east, the Attilo Dome complex and its nearby vents were constructed by a series of more than a dozen eruptions between 130,000 and 8,700 years ago. The base of this dome complex formed first, only to be followed by Strombolian eruptions constructing the surrounding islands. A series of as many as half a dozen eruptions occurred between the recently formed islands around 60,000 and sometime between 24,000 and 8,700 years ago. And finally, the massive rhyolite lava dome that formed Bassel Uzo Island to the north erupted around 60,000 years ago. All of these aforementioned eruptions were explosive, specifically primarily Vulcanian in nature, meaning if the Panarea volcanic complex were to ever erupt again, something similar could be expected with a likelihood of pyroclastic flow generation. However, in recent times, Panarea Island has been seemingly inactive, while the dome complex to the east has only erupted at a rate of about once every 6,000 years on average. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member for Scythia33 for supporting my work.